This is what's going on. Me and Darius done. Deal and done like RH. He play, he calling me after he left the lunch party and messaging me talking about he's sorry. I had to block his number so he could get the message. I should have never take he on when he come up to me skinning his teeth in barbecue barn. From the time I see he with tenders, I should have known he failed. Because everybody know wingdings is life.
Ladies and gentlemen, our second place winner is CircleSquare by Claudia Clarke.
This is actually my first book. My intention was to publish it towards the middle of last year, but that timing did not work out. Then I realized that the deadline for this competition was in August, and it was from Published Works. So I decided to hold on off on publication and submit it to the competition and see what would happen. Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm glad to hear that you entered the first time and that you managed to do so well in the competition. Any words of wisdom, any words of advice for budding Barbadian writers?
If you have a story to write, get it out there, because believe you me, they just live in your head and haunt you and won't let you sleep or get rest until you commit them to paper. Practice your craft, believe in yourself. I think we have to believe in our stories and not just consume other people's stories. We have a voice that needs to be heard, so I would like to see more people writing and publishing. When you search on the internet or on Amazon, it's so hard to find published works. Yes, it's expensive, but I think we really need to try a lot more in that area so we can put our work out there for other people to read.
I ain't speak to Trina since then, ain't neither. I guess I would speak back to she eventually, because blood thicker than water. Next thing is, Barbados has made me tired. The only way it does get through here is if you went to a big up school or you family big up. That's why I ain't vote for a boy in the elections. Walking about talking about them going to create jobs my tail, and know them ain't going to do one thing for nobody but themselves. Don't care what you try to do in Barbados. Them just find a way to stop poor people from getting through.
So tell us a little bit about your piece and what inspired it.
The piece is Mrs. She is a Barbadian young lady who, on the surface of it, is a person who seems to be very flamboyant, but there's a lot of substance to her. It is written entirely in Bajan. There are three pieces on Mrs. in the collection. So we follow her and see what happens to her through various occasions throughout the book.
I went in the bedroom and fall asleep watching TV. I was tired, because I had spent the day all about the place buying hair that people at home did want, and a few things I could hustle up and decide. One, Kanisha asked me to buy a black jumpsuit for she, and had me up and down taking pictures of the jumpsuits I see, and sending them to she, and she didn't see one damn jumpsuit she liked, though I sent she about 20 pictures. Got me standing up in people's store holding my phone in the air to get free Wi-Fi. And she and Barbados racking back like the queen of friggin' Sheba, telling me walk around a little more and see what the other stores got in.
What inspired it? I just love to listen to Bajan people. I love to listen to how they talk. I love to look at how they dress. I observe people a lot. That's my inspiration. I love to read, and I want to write a book about Barbados. I want us to read our stories. I'm tired of us consuming other people's culture. So that was really my inspiration.